Okay, we are in Plattsmouth today to work with Bernie, who is right over there. Now, Bernie has some issues with people he doesn't know. He's a newly adopted dog. He lives with two newfies, and the other two newfies were brought home as puppies. Very soft, more traditional, what you would expect from a newfie. I'm not saying he's a Cujo. He's the same breed that Cujo was. But he has some resource guarding problems, and he has bit people in relation to that. Now, that I don't necessarily always call, actually frequently, it is not an aggressive thing. It's a guarding of resources, which is a natural thing for any animal in the wild to do. We on a desert island would resource guard our supplies against other people that might take them as well. So when we came down the steps, he wasn't barking, and the guardian said, "Oh, that's good news, he's not barking." And as soon as we got to this little step, which is why we stopped here, he started barking. He was up on the fence earlier, he's not now. I wanted to kind of give him a chance to settle down a little bit. He had a little bit of a pause in barking. I was gonna use that to approach him, but of course I'm talking. So we're gonna go and meet him. We're going to keep him in the fence. We're probably going to talk for about an hour before we even start working with it, if we do at all, depending on how he reacts. But I want to try to use this opportunity to gauge him where he's free in an outdoor environment. For dogs, the more confined space they're in, sometimes that can amplify some of the things that we don't, some behaviors that we, and interactions we don't like. So being outside, you see, he barked, he alerted, he said, "Hey, I see you, I know that you're here." But now he's kind of wandering around, he's sniffing, you see his body language looks a lot more relaxed. So if you have the opportunity when you're approaching a dog to stop, give the dog a chance to settle itself down at enough a distance. Just like us, if somebody says, "Hey, I'm gonna punch you," but they're at the end of the block, you don't feel as immediately threatened. If they are running at you saying, "I'm gonna punch you," you're gonna feel a little bit more on guard, or if they're right close proximity to you. So for dogs, distance can equal respect, and distance can also help a dog feel more comfortable. So by kind of waiting at this distance and giving him a chance to bark it out a little bit, he wasn't too territorial about it. I mean, he was territorial, but he wasn't aggressive in his barking from what I heard. And so now you can see, shaking it off, shaking, self-grooming, licking. Those are signs that a dog does when it's more relaxed. If a dog is really worked up, it's not going to do any of those things. Also, won't take a treat. So if he takes these treats, that's going to be a good sign for us in terms of how he perceives us. So we're going to go ahead and approach, and this time he might, if he barks, we might stop again. I would like to keep this video from being too long, so we may push the boundaries a little bit more than normal, but if you have a dog that's like this, you want to try to approach him in a kind of a quasi staggered fashion. Now the other thing I'm doing, I'm walking backwards trying not to fall down.
Don't fall
down
the stairs.
Thank you. I appreciate you letting me know. I would have definitely fallen down those stairs. But for a dog, this is confrontational, this is approachable, behind you is defenseless. Now, if you have a dog that's aggressive, sometimes turning your back to it can trigger a response, so it's not a good way to deal with it. But sideways is more approachable. So you're gonna notice when I approach him, I'm gonna lower myself, I'm gonna try to give him my side profile to keep him from feeling more threatened or to stay in the line of sight, I'm just gonna walk across the grass right here. So we'll see how he is. You can see, the closer we get, the more animated he's starting to get. Hey buddy. So a little bit of licking the lips, which is a sign of anxiety. Hey buddy, I'm gonna ask you not to interact with him. You can say stuff, but we just don't want to, there we go. So that's a good sign, using his nose. Yeah, it's over there, buddy. There you go. So I wanna just develop a bit of a positive association. So again, I'm lowered, he's to my side. I wanna give him a chance to kind of sniff me without feeling threatened. Oh, very good signs. What a good, happy dog. Yes, a little licking. There you go, buddy. Oh, sitting down, also a good sign. Taking it, I feel his teeth, he's not nipping at me. Good job, buddy. Yeah. So again, if you have a dog that's reactive, if you can take your time, that I don't really interpret as, they see the tail going around. I think that's more of a protest. So why did you stop giving me treats? More than I'm not comfortable with you being here. Bernie, sit. 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 All right, this is Bernie's greeting. We'll pick it up a little bit later on in the session.